In this FlexSim Basics video, we're going to discuss port connections and the role they play in a simulation model. Before we begin, let's bring in a few objects that are found in a basic simulation model. Click and drag to pull these objects from the library into the 3D view. A source, a queue, three processors, an operator, and a sink. These resources can work together to move flow items through the model, but they won't be able to do anything unless they're connected to one another. A connection is a way to establish the relationships needed between objects to define a flow. An item exits through the output port of one object and enters through the input port of another, and a connection is the way to define which object is the input and which is the output. Each output-to-input relationship defines a possible routing between objects. So for any possible routing choice you want the model to have, you must have a connection that defines it. Objects can be connected in one of two ways. The first is by clicking the Connect Objects button in the toolbar, which puts you in connection mode. From here, you simply use your mouse to left-click two different objects, establishing an input-output connection between them, and then pressing the Escape key on your keyboard to leave connection mode. The other way is a little faster, and involves holding the A key on your keyboard, making the connection with your mouse, and then releasing the A key to leave connection mode. Using your preferred method, connect the source to the queue. An output port will be created on the first object you click, and a corresponding input port will be created on the second object you click. You can see a red arrow pointing away from the source, connected to a red arrow pointing into the queue. We now have created a relationship between these objects. Items that are created at the source will now flow to the queue. We can now connect the rest of the objects. Using your preferred method, connect the queue to each processor, which each connect to the sink. If you follow the red arrows, you'll see that we now have a flow from the source all the way to the sink, with three unique paths that items can take once they've exited the queue. Click Reset and run the model to see how the items flow through the model. There is another connection type available in FlexSim called a center port connection. Let's say we want to use that operator to help process items at the topmost processor. Could we use a regular connection to create this relationship? No, because it wouldn't involve the input and output of items. We can, however, connect their center ports together, which will create a reference between two resources. Just like with regular connections, center connections can be made in one of two ways. The first is by clicking the arrow next to the Connect Objects button in the toolbar and selecting Connect Center Ports, which puts you in center port connection mode. Connect two resources exactly as we did before, and then press the Escape key on your keyboard to leave connection mode. You can also hold the S key on your keyboard, make the connection, and then release the S key to leave connection mode. You'll see that instead of red arrows, center port connections result in red squares. This is to show that the connection is a reference connection and doesn't deal with input and output. We now have the ability to assign the operator to process items at the processor, because the connection allows us a way to reference these resources to one another. At some point, you'll need to remove a connection from your model. To do so, either use the Disconnect Objects button in the toolbar or use the shortcuts on your keyboard. Q for a regular connection and W for a center port connection. Choose whichever feels more comfortable and click between the objects in exactly the same order as when you first made the connection. Thank you for watching. For more information on FlexSim products or to view more tips and tricks for successful modeling, please visit www.flexsim.com.